Something needs to change.
The true tragedy of our time is still unfolding across the globe, barely noticeable from day to day. I'm talking about the loss of our planet's wild places, its biodiversity.
Humans are constantly doing things to increase the amount of carbon in our atmosphere, like burning fossil fuels and traveling by non-electric cars. The more carbon in our atmosphere causes there to be an increase in the temperature, and an increase in temperature causes the oceans to be more acidic. Corals are very sensitive to pH changes, and this is the result. Coral reefs hold so much biodiversity that they are known as the rainforest of the ocean. Without them, humans will disappear. This is the result of chemical pollution. It is called algae bloom, and it prevents oxygen and sunlight from reaching organisms near the bottom of the waterways. These organisms die, float to the top, and the algae bloom feeds on the dead organisms. This is a giant fishing fleet. These fleets can be found in every country all over the world. They started in 1950, and the first year they caught tons of fish. But just a few years after, nets around the world came up empty, and fish populations were devastated.
In such places, huge shoals of fish gather. Is that our fishing fleets are just as good at finding those hot spots as are the fish. When they do, they're able to gather the concentrated shoals with ease.
Bluefin tuna are constantly competing with fishing fleets for food. These bait balls provide food for many large predators. These highly prized fish are sought around the world for their meat. The demand for tuna is one of the largest out of all fish in the ocean. And because of these fishing fleets, more than 90% of large predators in the ocean have died. One of the best ways we can restore our biodiversity on this earth is by using renewable energy. Sources like sun, water, wind, and geothermal are all sources of renewable energy that would last forever.
When you think about it, we're completing a journey. 10,000 years ago, as hunter-gatherers, we lived a sustainable life because that was the only option. All these years later, it's once again the only option. We need to rediscover how to be sustainable, to move from being apart from nature to becoming a part of nature once again.